Welcome to Connection Card. In this short video, we will help you to understand the basics of adding and organizing contacts within Connection Card. In Connection Card, all individuals are referred to as persons, whether they are members, visitors, or regular attendees of your church, a prospect, or an outside contact or supporter. First, we will discuss adding and importing persons. Second, we will discuss attributes that affect person records. And lastly, we will discuss the person list, adding and importing persons. There are 5 ways to add or import persons to your database. The first is by clicking on the Persons menu, then selecting Add Person. Here you will have complete control over all possible fields and information about a person. You can fill in as much or as little information as you wish. Second, you can import a list of individuals by selecting Persons, Import Persons. This will require a CSV file or comma separated values file containing all of the persons you wish to import. This is a common format which can be created using spreadsheet software or exported from many other contact database products. The third way to create new persons is in kiosk mode, where the first two methods are intended to be used by your administrative users such as staff or volunteers in the office. Kiosk mode is intended to be used on-site during any of your gatherings or programming. Within kiosk mode, click on the Persons menu and select New Person. This will be a simplified form with only basic information about an individual. You may also set which of these is required when entered in kiosk mode. The fourth way is to create a new person using the Connection Card mobile app. Staff and leaders will have the option to create new individuals in the app, and the available fields in the app will be the same as those in kiosk mode. The fifth way persons get added to your account is when they enter information themselves, either via a digital guest card or when they sign up online for an event or camp. Attributes that affect person records. There are many different attributes that affect person records and how they are saved. In this video, we will look at 3 of them. First, classifications. Classifications are used to define an individual's role within your church, as well as their role within any group that they are part of. You can manage and create classifications by clicking on the Manage menu and then selecting Classifications. All classifications are available to be used church-wide or within any group. For example, John Jones could be assigned the member classification within your church, but could be assigned the leader classification within Saturday night small group. Your options are limitless. Second, custom fields. You may create an unlimited number of custom fields in order to save additional and sortable information for any person. Custom fields may be plain text, a date, a yes or no option, or may link to another person. Third, department settings. To change which fields are requested and or required in kiosk mode and in the mobile app, these settings can be customized for each individual department. You can get to these settings by selecting Groups, Departments, click on Settings for the desired department, and scroll down to find Information Collected under the New Person Registration section. Click where it says Click here for Settings. Person List. Selecting Persons, Person List will take you to a complete list of all persons within your organization. Use any of the options at the top of the page to filter results. You can also click on the header of each column to sort persons by that column. Alternatively, to view a roster of any individual group, go to the Groups menu, then select the type of group you wish to view, and then click on Roster for the desired group. This has been an overview of persons and contacts within Connection Card. If you still have questions, please review the help documents and tutorials specific to each aspect.